much my type. You much my type.
And, you know, I think I fit in well. I'm going to get a pair of cowboy boots and a hat, and I'm going to be all right. I already have some. I just didn't bring them with me. I promise you we'll give you our best effort in every area to make this a program that all can be proud of. Thank you. Guns up.
Thank you. That was the scene earlier today as Texas Tech introduces new men's basketball coach Tubby Smith from United Spirit Arena. I'm Zach Long with Nick Kosmider. Welcome in everyone to RedRaiders.com. And Nick, after a 19-day search for a new head coach, Kirby Hocutt and the Texas Tech administration go with Tubby Smith.
Yeah, it was a long process, and it seemed to be even longer for those of us kind of covering every twist and turn. They interviewed about, you know, upwards of eight different people. You know, I think in the end they landed on a guy who has, in 22 seasons, made the NCAA tournament 17 times. He's a one-time national champion at Kentucky in 1998. And more than anything, this program, after two disastrous years and even going back a little further than that, is in need of some real stability. And they feel like this is a guy who has never skirted the waters with the NCAA, always run clean programs, that he can be a guy who sort of lays a foundation, just kind of brings them back to earth at least, because that's certainly not been something that they've been able to do here in the last couple years. So I think a stability hire, but they also believe, given his credentials, that they can be a consistent winner and finally be a competitor in the Big 12.
And the second question, which you brought up right off the bat in the press conference, is why for Tubby Smith? Why does he want to come to Texas Tech, and why does he think he can be successful here?
Yeah, I mean, this is going to be, I would imagine, his greatest challenge. I mean, every coaching position that you take on is going to introduce its own challenges, certainly being at Kentucky and the pressures that are associated with that. He felt those, you know, he kind of gets a lot of pressure at the end, and he never even missed the NCAA tournament. But this, just in terms of what he has in front of him, I mean, you're talking about a team who has gone 4-32 in the Big 12 the last two seasons. Just a lot of work to do, and for somebody in the later stages of his career, you know, it's fair to ask, you know, kind of why would you be wanting to kind of put yourself into this? But kind of as you said, he told us a little bit about that today.
Well, it's like in recruiting. I always tell players it's good to be needed, but it's probably more important to be wanted. And I sense that from Kirby Hocutt and Lawrence and Kent when they came to talk to me. And when my lawyer, Ricky Leff, called to say, hey, they'd be interested in talking to me, I was only 2 days removed from being dismissed. So right away you start to analyze, you know, the potential of a program. And I've known Coach Myers for years. I've watched the progress that we had from you know, previous coaches, and you say, okay, number one, I want to get back on the horse right away and get going, because I feel like I have a lot to offer and a lot of energy. There's a lot of good years left in me to coach. So right away, I know that you're in a top conference in the country. The Big 12 is one of the top conferences, major conferences in the country. I know the competition is going to be outstanding. All these things come together to form the opinion that we can win here, and that's why we're very excited about this opportunity.
So, Nick, after hearing that from Coach Smith, we talk about Kirby Hocutt. And one of the things you and I have talked about was one of his mentors in life is Joe Castiglione at Oklahoma. He made a stability hire 2 years ago in Long Kruger. You look at this hire now, and you can't help but think that's exactly what Texas Tech is after. What do you think this hire means for the future of the basketball program?
You know, I think that it's, like you said, they're hiring for stability. And, it, you know, again, Tubby Smith is a guy who has won, even at Minnesota the last 6 years, three NCAA tournament appearances, two NIT appearances, and you know, while that was starting to not cut it at Minnesota, if they can get into the NIT, I mean, that's sort of a far away from where they're at right now. So, you know, he's not a guy who has had strings of losing seasons or anything like that. He's won everywhere that he has been, and you get that done in a certain way, which I think he will do with just kind of the very hard-working, grinded-out type of basketball. You know, they're probably not going to be the next Dunk City or anything like that.
Right, exactly.
You're not going to see that kind of base. But again, he's just a solid guy, a lot like Lon Kruger, that's been able to go places, implement his style, and just be a very accountable, very strong-willed guy. And I think for right now, they'll take that.
You know, and he's going to get to work right now, and we're going to get to work too with a lot more content on the hiring of Tubby Smith as the new men's basketball coach for Texas Tech. You know where you're going, LubbockOnline.com, RedRaiders.com for full coverage of the hiring of Tubby Smith. For Nick Cosmider, I'm Zach Long. We'll see you next time.